Okay, we're back. Time for a fantastic voyage of Goddard.
According to the reading I took, the parasitic brains were strongest in the audiovisual center of the CPU. We'll need to make our way through Goddard's systems to get there. But there were minor drains everywhere, so they could be anywhere in his system.
So as you can see, we're inside Goddard. And the whole thing is just to try to find a Flea-Bot that's making Goddard itch. A very big one. But there's little ones too. And when I said in a previous video that I've been working hard to try to get every coin so I can upgrade all of our abilities and weapons, well, I just did. Watch. Jeremy's tornado blaster can make a big tornado. Tammy, he can now shoot 3 stars, and when you hold A, it'll create a big star. Well, you see what really happens. SpongeBob's remain the same. Danny's is awesome. Yeah! And look, and during his normal attacks, he actually made a flip and stomp instead of like a swing kick. What else?
Go and go!
Danny's spaceship and Whale is more powerful, SpongeBob's Bubble Bomb even more powerful, and the Doodle Bob even more powerful, maybe bigger, maybe not. See, some are a bit similar to their first upgrades, but maybe a bit more powerful. Well, anyways, let's go on. Brian, not into Goddard's digestive system might have an interesting effect. It does. The only differences that you might see is their main attacks. Flea! Come here, Flea. See, he's been changed into a toy by Timmy's upgraded ability. The fleas are very annoying. They jump away from you if you get too close. So you pretty much had to use Jimmy or Timmy in order to do it. Them. This level involves a very annoying boss. Let's just hope that this game won't freeze, because every time I'm in this level, my game freezes, and it's so annoying. Mostly in the boss. Not the final boss, the boss before it. Let's get tiny. Oh, looks like we had to turn back. This level's got two new music. This one is one of them. I actually quite like this soundtrack. Because there are a lot of soundtracks in this game I didn't enjoy at all. Only Clef can carry these. Since he's very strong. Well, this level is very hard. It's pretty easy to get lost. Get over here. Well, well. If it isn't the music that we heard since Danny's World. I actually believe that you can stun those fleas since they're too fast and they hop around like nuts. So the only way to deal with that is just use either Timmy or Jimmy. Since we're finally at his world, I am playing him, mostly. Hey, get back here. Whoops. Get back here, you little parasite. That's a new music too. Falling a lot. Pressing X. I still find it disappointing because you can't double jump. But you can on any later Nicktoons games. Wait. Now! But I can freeze them! See, only long shots can deal with these nasty little fleas. But close ones are not. You can't. Oh, I hate that guy. He's called Goddard's Artificial Immune System Robots. Ah! Only Danny can deal with him. He's protected by a glass. He's now stunned. Overshadow him. Oops. And only these things can go through that. I don't think you can destroy them. Oh, you can. See, whenever you go through this, well, on your own, another of these things appear. It's annoying. That's why you should overshadow them. Once you're past with that thing, get out of it and get rid of it. He's gone. More fleas. All this. God's got a lot of junk in this place. He only eats his lug nuts, or whatever they're called. Ah, I need that. Hey! guess it's fine to play into me sometimes in this level. I mean, he's been to Jimmy's world. You guys seen the Timmy and Jimmy Hour movies? Power Hours. Silly me. I thought it was pretty funny because both Jimmy and Timmy, they rhyme.